वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू शिक्षक 360 एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द बेसिकली पार्ट फोर ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ फॉरेन एक्सचेंज मैनेजमेंट. दिस इज अ शॉर्ट सेशन एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ओनली ऑन द ट्रेजरी बिल्स. क्लियर? इज इन द लास्ट सेशन वी हैव स्टार्टेड द ट्रेजरी बिल्स, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट वंस अगेन. एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस सम इम्पॉर्टेंट न्यूमेरिकल्स ऑन द ट्रेजरी बिल्स. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट अवर सेशन एंड वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू. सो ट्रेजरी बिल्स, व्हाट आर इनिशियली द ट्रेजरी बिल्स? So these are issued by the government of India. Clear? Treasury bills are initially basically issued by the government of India. How government of India issued treasury bill? Basically through the RBI. Clear? Through which intermediary? Basically through the Reserve Bank of India. Clear? So these are issued treasury bills. Basically these are issued by the government of India through Reserve Bank for maturity swap. Clear? So basically you have to remember that it is a money market instrument, as we have discussed money market. So it is issued by the government of India and through Reserve Bank of India for maturities of how much their maturities. It is basically maturities less than 1 year. It is basically issued in 391 days maturity or 182 days maturity or 364 days maturity. Clear? For predetermined amounts. Clear? Basically these are issued by the government of India through Reserve Bank for maturities of 91 days, 182 days and 364 days for predetermined amounts. Clear? For predetermined amounts. So the interest is by way of discount. So the bills are priced below rupees 100. Clear? So the interest is by way of discount. So the bills are priced below rupees 100. Clear? So the interest is by way of discount. Clear? Basically, the interest earned or the benefit earned on the treasury bills is basically by the way of discount. So the bills are priced below rupees 100. Clear? So the bills are priced below rupees 100. So the bills are priced below rupees 100. Clear? Basically like that. Treasury bills are issued. Clear? Treasury bills are issued on discount. Like if the treasury bill is of rupees, we can say that 10,000. So it is issued at 9920. Clear? It is issued at 9920. And on the maturity, you will get 10,000. Clear? So that is 80 rupees. Initially, you have to pay this much amount. And after the maturity, you have to get this much amount. Clear? So this is the interest. Clear? This is the interest or this is the benefit you will get investing in the treasury bills. Clear? So you have to remember that the interest is by way of discount. Clear? Or you have to remember this point also. Treasury bills issue at discount. Clear? Issues at a discount. So here we will discuss one example which we have also discussed. So for example, first of all, what is there are two formulas regarding the one is discount yield, one is investment yield. Clear? One is investment yield or annualized yield. Clear? There are two things in that. And the formulas of both are different. Clear? So discount yield is basically it's equal to face value minus market value. MV is equal to market value upon face value into 365 by N. N is the number of days of maturity. Clear? N is the number of days of maturity. Clear? So this is discount yield is equal to face value minus market value upon face value into 365 by N. Our investment yield or annualized yield. Clear? So this is basically is equal to face value minus market value upon market value into 365 upon N. Clear? Into 365 upon N. Clear? So these are basically the two cases. Clear? These are basically the two cases of that. So here it is basically saying that treasury bill is of 91 days is priced at this one. Clear? Basically, face value it is 100, priced at 99.26. Clear? Yielding at interest, it is N is equal to 91 days. Clear? So you have to calculate. clear, you have to calculate that, clear. They have all mentioned, which is also known as implicit yield, clear. So you have to, in the end, you have to multiply by 100 to get the implicit yield or interest, clear, how much they will earn interest, clear. Here, this is also multiplied by 100, clear. So in this way, you will get the answer. Okay, so now this is also the formula yield, clear. This is also the formula of yield. So it is formula for the yield, that is basically annualized yield. Or investment yield, clear. So in some question they will ask these types. We will discuss also all these questions. So and formula for the yield on the treasury bills, yield is equal to face value minus price purchase price upon purchase price into 365 upon n. Yeah, so where f is the face value, p is the purchase price, and n is the number of days to maturity. Clear, n is the number of days to maturity. Clear, so this is the yield of a treasury bill. So the price of treasury bill, very, very important point. How the price of the treasury bill is determined? Clear, how the price of the treasury bill is determined? So let's discuss. So the price of treasury bill is determined through an auction process. Clear, you have to remember that the price of the treasury bill is determined through an auction process, where banks and the primary dealers are the main participants. Clear, basically who are the main participants? Basically, where banks and the primary dealers are the main participants. Clear, so the price of treasury bills is determined through an auction process. Clear, the price of the treasury bill is determined through an auction process, where the banks and the primary dealers are the main participants. Clear, where the banks and the primary dealers are the main participants. The auction, however, clear, the auction, however, is open to all players in the financial markets. Clear, the auction, however, is open. The auction, however, is open to all the players. The auction, however, is open to all the players in the financial market, including financial institutions, mutual funds, corporates, other business entities, as also individuals. Clear? So the auction, however, is open to all the players in the financial market. Basically, who are the players in the financial market, including financial institutions, mutual funds, clear, financial institutions, mutual funds, corporates, other business entities, as also individuals. So treasury bills are issued on fixed dates. Clear, you have to remember that. Treasury bills, basically, they are issued on fixed dates and for pre-fixed amounts. Clear, they are issued also on fixed dates and for pre-fixed amounts. Currently, like 91 days treasury bills is issued weekly on each Wednesday. Clear, like 91 day treasury bill basically issued on Wednesday is, and it is weekly issued. Clear, every week it is issued. So 182 days, clear, 182 days treasury bill is also issued on Wednesday, but fortnightly, clear, but fortnightly basically means that gap of 1 week. Clear, like there are, we can say that 1, 2, 3, 4. So if this week is it is issued, then it is issued in the this week, clear. So this is preceding the non-Friday on a reporting Monday, clear. So 182 days treasury bill is issued fortnightly on Wednesday preceding the non-reporting Friday, clear, preceding the non-reporting Friday, clear. So it is like first week, second week, third week, fourth week. It is if in the first week it is non-reporting Friday, so then treasury bill is issued on this day, clear. And if it is issued in the third week on non-reporting Friday, then it is basically issued on this day. Clear, so it depends which is the non-reporting Friday, clear. That is also fortnightly, clear. That is also fortnightly. So 182 days treasury bills is issued fortnightly on Wednesday preceding the non-reporting Friday. Clear, if it is 182 is also issued on Friday and 91 days is also issued on Friday, and 364 days treasury bill is also issued fortnightly on Wednesday preceding reporting Friday. Clear, here we can say that second week it is a reporting Friday and fourth week it is on a reporting Friday. So 364 days issued this week, 364 days issued this week, clear. So it depends upon case to case. So treasury bills are issued on fixed dates and for pre-fixed amounts. Treasury bills are issued on fixed dates and for pre-fixed amounts. Currently, 91 days treasury bills is issued weekly on each Wednesday. Similarly, 182 days treasury bills. 182 days treasury bills is issued fortnightly. 182 days treasury bills is issued fortnightly on Wednesday, preceding the non-reporting Friday. Similarly, 364 days treasury bills. Similarly, 364 days treasury bills is issued fortnightly. Is issued fortnightly on Wednesday, preceding reporting Friday. This is the way. And next one is for bank treasury. For bank treasury, investment in treasury bills is a convenient way of parking short-term surpluses in a risk-free investment. Basically, money market, or we can say that interbank market. It is a risk-free market. It is a totally a risk-free market. Investment in treasury bills is a convenient way of parking short-term surpluses in a risk-free investment. Yielding interest generally higher than the overnight call money markets. Basically, in the T-bills, basically, there is higher interest rate. Yielding interest generally higher than the overnight call money rates. This is the question of 2020 CAB. Is the interest rate higher on the treasury bills than the call money markets or not? So basically, they will directly pick up the line, this line. So the interest rates generally higher than the overnight call money rates. Treasury bills have a liquid secondary market. Basically, primary market, there are two markets, primary market and secondary market. So here, treasury bills have a liquid secondary market and the treasury bills constitutes a valid benchmark rate for debt paper. So treasury bills have a liquid secondary market and a treasury bills yields constitutes a valid benchmark rate for the debt paper. Now there is one more, FIMDA. FIMDA. Fixed income money market derivatives association. Fixed income money market and derivatives association of India. And Reuters is one organization, who publishes all information, Fixed Income Money Market and Derivatives Association of India and Reuters collaborate to publish benchmark treasury bill, yields for 1 week to 1 year based on the residual maturity of treasury bills in circulation. They have to publish all the details regarding that. So Fixed Income Money Market and Derivatives Association of India and Reuters collaborate to publish benchmark treasury bills yields. Collaborate to publish benchmark treasury bills yields for 1 week to 1 year. Based on the residual maturity of treasury bills in circulation. So the treasury bill, like other government securities, is in electronic form. So the treasury bill, basically like other government securities, it is in basically electronic form and is to be held in the SGL account or constituent SGL account maintained by the banks. Basically, it is to be held in the SGL account. Why? Because in the SGL account, it is very easy to sell and buy. And it is to be held in the SGL account or constituent SGL account. SGL account or constituent SGL account maintained by the banks. Clear? Maintained by the banks. Clear? SGL accounts, basically that is to be maintained by the banks with the Reserve Bank of India. Clear? SGL account is basically maintained by the banks with the Reserve Bank of India. So, what is SGL? SGL basically stands for subsidiary ledger account. Clear? One more question. Basically, SGL is basically subsidiary ledger account. Clear? And all transactions are basically done through this subsidiary ledger account. So, and it's to be held in the SGL account or constant SGL account maintained by the banks with the Reserve Bank of India through depository participants. Clear? Through depository are also now operated through SGL account. Clear? To facilitate retail sales of government securities. Clear? To facilitate retail sales of government securities. Clear? I have forgot one word is G. Clear? Subsidiary journal ledger account. Clear? Subsidiary journal ledger account. Okay. So secondary market settlement of treasury bills takes place through Clearing Corporation of India. Clear? Basically, how the settlement of these treasury bills takes place? Basically, takes place through the Clearing Corporation of India Limited, CCIL. Clear? So settlement of the treasury bills basically takes place through the Clearing Corporation of India Limited, CCIL. Clear? So now there is one formula of the calculation of the treasury bill. Clear? This is basically specified on the RBI website. Directly I will present for you to calculate basically what are they want to say. Clear? How is the yield of treasury bill calculated? Clear? As they have mentioned this point, how the yield of the treasury bill is calculated. So it is calculated as per the following formula. Clear? If there is directly they are asking yield. Clear? So you have to implement this formula. As there is P purchase value, at that time we have discussed it is to be as market value. Clear? And 100 we have to discuss as face value. Clear? This is the number of days. Clear? So where yield is equal to 100 minus P upon P into 365 upon D into 100. Clear? Where P is purchase price, or we can also mark it as market value. D is the number of days to maturity. Clear? Day count. Actual number of days to maturity. So like here, there is one example. Assuming that the price of the 91-day treasury bill issues at 98.50. So it is a market value. And face value it is to be 100. So the yield on the same would be, clear, it is basically 91 days. So we have to put it 100 minus 98.20 upon 98.20 into 365 upon 91. Why 91? Because it is a 91 day treasury bill into 100. So it comes out to be 7.3521%. Clear? It comes out to be 7.3521%. On the other hand, after say 41 days, clear, 41 days, what is the yield? 41 days, basically it is of 91 days. Now after 41 days, how many days is to be left? 50 days to the maturity. Clear? So after 41 days, if the same treasury bill is trading at 99, clear, earlier the face value it is to be 90, earlier the market value it is to be 98.20. Now the market value it is to be 99. So the yield then would be, clear, the yield then would be, this yield is equal to 100 minus 99 upon 99 into 365 upon 50. Why it is 50? Because now there are only 50 days left for the maturity. Clear? Now there are only 50 days left for the maturity. Clear? Into 100. So it comes out to be 7.3737%. Clear? So this is the yield. So these are basically the basic questions they will ask in the examination. Clear? Basically how to calculate the yield. Now we'll provide you some more questions. Clear? Before moving towards the question, I have once again elaborate formulas for you. Basically, there are two formulas which we have to discuss: discount yield and investment yield. So discount yield is equal to face value minus market value upon face value into 365 upon n into, and in the investment yield it is to face value minus market value upon market value into 365. Clear? Which we have discussed here is it is also investment yield or annualized yield. Clear? So now it one question on your screen now, a treasury bill, basically a treasury bill. Wait a minute. A treasury bill in 91 days. Clear? So what if first of all they are asking yield? Clear? So remaining maturity of 73 days. Clear? So it has a remaining maturity of 9 and it is to price at 99. Clear? So it is 100 minus 99 upon 99 into 365 upon 73 into it is 91 days, but remaining maturity is 73 days. This is the 2019 question, directly paper exam question, previous year question is this one. So into 100. So if we are going to calculate, if we are going to calculate this, so what will be the answer we will get? It is to be one, it is 365 by 99 into 73. Okay, as it is presented in the exam that you are able to use the calculator. So if you are going to calculate, it is comes out to be 5.05%. 5.05%, as many of students are also giving the answer. So option number B is the correct answer. Clear? So these questions are very, very easy. If you are basically familiar with these types of questions, then you are easily score the marks. Clear? As many students are facing problem that they are asking, sir, many new questions are asked in exam. These are not the new questions. Basically, they are not familiar that much. Clear? As we have discussed in detail. Basically, one special session on the treasury bills. Clear? So, that's why. So, you have to properly go through all the parts. Clear? Now, next question. Like, this question I have also provided in the Telegram group. So, an investor purchases a 6 months. Clear? Now, earlier it is 91 days. Now, it is 6 months. Basically, 182 days treasury bill. With this is the face value, par value, and this is the discount value or basically face value, market value. And the investor holds the treasury bills to maturity, his annualized yield. Clear? Here they will also annualize it. So annualized yield basically formalized this to be face value minus market value upon market value into 365 upon n into 100. So a face value it is to be 10,000. Market value is to be 9850. So it comes out to be 150 upon 9850 into 365 upon 182 into 100. So when we are going to calculate, clear? So when we are going to calculate, it is to 150 into 100 into 365. Okay. So then divide by 9850, then divide by 182. So it comes out to be 3.054. So it is basically up to two decimal places. We are going to calculate 3.05. So option number C is the answer. Clear? Hope it is clear to all of you. You have to remember what they are going to say that. Clear? So here investor purchases a 6 months treasury bill. Clear? If it is 6 months, then we have to take the 182 days. Treasury bill with the 10,000 par value or face value and 9850, it is to be the market value or the purchase price. And the investor holds the treasury bills to maturity. So his annualized yield is how much percent? Clear? So it has to be 3.05%. Now, next question. So an investor purchases a 6 month, same question. 182 days treasury bill with 10,000 par value for this is the face value and this is the purchase value. And the investor holds the treasury bill to maturity. The treasury bill discount yield. Clear? This is the different word as totally all the question is same. So that's why I'm going to discuss again and again. Here they will ask discount yield. Clear? Here will they ask discount yield. So discount yield is equal to face value minus market value upon face value into 365 upon n into 100. So it is to be face value, it is to be 10,000. 150 upon face value it is to be 10,000 into 365 upon 182 into 100. So here it is, calculate this. Clear? So now we have left only three things. 15 into 365 divide by 1820. Clear? Divide by 1820. So I think it comes out to be 3.008, or it comes out to be, we can say that 3.01. Clear? 3.01. So it is the answer. Clear? So it is the answer. Clear? So the investor holds the treasury bill to maturity. So the treasury bill discount yield is to be 3.01. Clear? So option number C is the answer here. Now move to the next question. So this question is for practice for all of you. So let's discuss first of all. So the investor purchases a 6 months treasury bill. Clear? The investor purchases a 6 months treasury bill with the face value, this one, for this amount. Clear? 9850. Same statement. If the investor had sold, clear? Now the investor had sold that treasury bill after 100 days. Clear? Now the investor had sold the treasury bill after 100 days for rupees 9940. Her annualized yield will be, clear? Her annualized yield will be, clear? Now this question you have to do practice. We will discuss this question in the Telegram group. So investor purchases a 6 months, 182 days basically, treasury bill with rupees 10,000 par value for this one. Clear? Face value test to be rupees 10,000 and this market value is to be 9850. Now if the investor had sold the treasury bill, clear? If the investor had sold the treasury bill after 100 days for rupees 9940, clear? Now the investor had sold the treasury bill basically after 100 days for how much amount? Basically 9940. Sir, so her annual yield will be -%. So her annual yield would be -%. So you have to think over the question, how you will solve the question. So it is four option: 3.34%, 3.29%, 1.83% and 1.80%. Clear? So you have to answer basically how much is the annualized yield for this one. Clear? So in our today's session, we will have to discuss up to this much point. And in our next session, we have to discuss cash management pills, certificate of deposits, commercial paper. Clear? All these instruments we have to discuss in our next session. So thanks to all of you for attending this session and hope all of you are like the session, because in this session we have discussed many new concepts, many numericals, which are very, very important for your examination. So thanks to all of you for attending this session.